Waddle's world. The Cavaliers are hiring Kenny Atkinson as head coach. He was the top assistant with Golden State. Does that do anything for you? I think the bigger news today is J.J. Redick was introduced as the Lakers head coach.
Yeah.
I think that's more interesting.
Kenny Atkinson, what, he did his best work in Brooklyn? Is that where he was?
Yeah, Brooklyn.
He had decent stuff there. Like, these guys, they're not long for any
It's a merry-go-round, isn't it, a little bit? I don't know about you, but, I mean, why doesn't LeBron just coach and play? I mean, at this point...
Are they allowed to? Can you be a player coach these days? I don't know why you can't be.
He should be owner-player coach.
It's because of the salary cap.
Oh, that's right. You told me that once before.
That's why they outlawed it. J.J. Redick did say in his introductory press conference he is done podcasting.
Oh, well, thank God for that. I mean, that should be the least he's... You know what I mean? Like, it's just silly.
Yeah, was that one of the main questions?
Right.
Will you and LeBron continue to podcast?
Well, he has his own that's very popular he's got as well.
He has a network, and that was, I think, one of the holdups with part of, like, the salary that the Lakers were offering, believe it or not.
Why, he had to match his podcasting salary?
No, if you build a podcast network, you can sell that for some very lucrative, you know... Look at what Dan Lebatard's done. Look at what Bill Simmons has done. They got massive money for, you know, just selling it to Spotify and DraftKings. So you can build a very profitable network.
You know, I'm watching that Clippers series called Clip.
Yes.
On Hulu. It's not very good.
Oh, with Ed Harris? O'Neal.
I wouldn't recommend it. I watched one episode. And J.J. Redick, he was on that team. So he's featured in it. And I don't know how much of this is true. Like, he had some run-ins with Chris Paul. And Doc recruiting him was, they show him in the bar with Doc as he's being recruited. It was interesting.
Let's go to baseball. Last night, Mets reliever Edwin Diaz was ejected for having a foreign substance on his pitching hand, that's an automatic 10-game suspension unless he appeals and wins the appeal, which he probably won't. The home plate umpire said it was extremely sticky. There's no real subjectivity after that. In other words, he can't really make his case. If they think it's too sticky, it's too sticky. They kick him out. But you know what's interesting? The team plays short a man for 10 days. You can't replace him.
They play with eight players?
Yeah.
They play with
one less reliever for 10 games, so that's interesting.
That does affect you.
Yeah, bullpens for sure. He's only the second player this year to be thrown out for sticky substance violation.
So he hadn't pitched, though. They checked his hands when he was coming in.
Yeah, they made that rule recently. Not recently, but when they started checking more, they said, we don't want to check the closer after he blows a game.
Right.
Because it's just too crazy. We're going to check him when he comes in from the bullpen.
Would they ever just say, wash your hands?
They have done that.
Throwing him out?
They have done that. And I don't know what the reasoning is for letting a guy wash and not wash. There's a little... gray area in some of this stuff, but he's facing suspension. Incidentally, there's only been 8 players that have been suspended since they started checking it more. 3 of them have been Mets. So,
what's going on there?
Read into it however you like.
Grimace's special sauce.
Right. Grimace has been a big deal there.
It's the Big Mac secret sauce.
So, Scottie Scheffler beats Tom Kim in a playoff to win the PGA Tour's Travelers. I think it's his 6th win this year on the tour, right?
Yes.
That ties Tiger Woods, who won 6 in 2009. Here's my question to you, who hosts a talk show every day. Like, I know golf is hard to talk about. Like, are we talking enough about Scottie Scheffler? I know he's boring, you know, you got arrested, all that. But like, he's turning into one of the greats in his sport. Like, rivaling, you know, he's not quite there with the championships, but he's rivaling runs that Tiger had.
It's a good point. And when was the most we talked about Scott Scheffler?
When he got arrested.
Yes.
When he got arrested. I don't know. Is it just that his personality is a little boring? But he is dominating.
I think so.
A sport that's hard to dominate week in and week out, year in and year out.
And it's golf. And if you're not different, like Tiger, you don't. You know what?
You don't break through necessarily.
Yes. There's split tours, too. That doesn't help him either.
Right. You're not playing against the best competition except in the majors, four times a year.
And how many of those does he have, guys? You know, like three, four?
How many majors does he have? He has two.
Only two. Okay. Yeah. So he's not quite Tiger-esque yet. But six wins this year, and it's only June.
I love how we say only two majors.
Right. Only two majors.
Only two.
And it's only June. That's all I have for you, I think.
What do you mean that's all you have?
What else do we have here?
We just started.
Buddy, we got 5 minutes on the clock here.
wait, that's all you have.
I told you I was going to do my best not to ruin this segment.
The sports stuff or the fun? Do you have fun stuff?
Oh, I have fun stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Should I go to that?
Yeah, you don't need to.
Oh, I thought maybe we go to commercial and break.
The one thing I wanted to bring up, Aloy's in the lineup tonight. Is that possible?
Look, he's hurting almost every night he takes the field. So if you're going to just gauge him, are you 100%? You're never going to get yes. You know what I mean?
I don't want
to. He's going to have to play while he's hurting.
How do I say this without sounding mean or like cruel?
We've already agreed that he's injury prone. So what you know, how much worse can it get?
If Aloy was an animal, would he be put down?
Oh, jeez.
You got Tyler to snicker on that one.
Think about it. If Aloy was a racehorse, he'd definitely be dead.
Well, they'd put him out to pasture at the very least. You want to soften the blow here.
With his legs, I think he'd be taken down.
He'd be put out to pasture. I don't know about taken down.
If he was a racehorse?
I mean, like, Eloy's probably... Here's my prediction. He's going to retire soon.
I think he'd be glued.
He's going to retire sooner rather than later. Whatever that is. I don't know if it's a year, 2 years, 3 years. He's going to retire before your normal retirement age. I think we could all agree with that.
He came back yesterday, yes?
Yes.
And
it was like a day early, too.
He was out with a leg injury again, yes?
Yes.
And he's already limping, yes?
Yes, he says he's sore.
How is that possible?
By the way.
He was just, I don't understand. If he's not as healthy as he possibly could be, right when he is finished with his rehab, when is he ever going to be healthy?
Never. I love this headline on WhiteSox.com. Now, this is not Scott Merkin. He was off. This is someone filling in. Did you see this headline? With Jimenez's return, Sox are just one shy of Big Three reunion.
Big Three?
Big Three reunion.
Let's guess the three.
I know.
Paul DeYoung, yeah, right? Exactly. He leads the team home runs.
Nicky Lopez.
It's Robert Moncada and Aloy.
I mean, it's a little aggressive to call them the Big Three when their peak was like 3 years ago.
This is like LeBron and Dwayne Wade.
Yeah. With Jimenez's return, Sox are just one shy of Big Three reunion. WhiteSox.com.
I think I'd still put the Sox Big Three up against whatever Cubs Big Three you could parcel together.
That's shot.
Now, the Cubs roster is better. I will give you that. The whole roster is far and away better. But Big Three, I think you might take Roberts.
I can't argue. I'm not going to get, like, all chesty. I can't get chesty because...
I mean, this goes to the point about them being boring.
They don't have a superstar.
No, if you told me Jimenez, Robert, and Moncada were healthy for a few months at a time, yeah, those three would probably be better than three Cub players, but they haven't been healthy, so it's just hard to judge.
So and then go pitchers, Mellor. And if you
I'll
go
say Crochet.
If you go Crochet and Fetty against Steele and Shota.
I think most people would take Crochet and Fetty.
Well, I think Crochet probably puts it over the top. That guy's the real deal. Are we trying to make the case the Sox are better than the Cubs?
No, they're not. They're not even close. And like Mellor said, the Cubs are deeper. But they're just,
I think that's the core of the Cubs' issue, is you've got a bunch of nice players on your roster, but that you do need, and this is what you've been saying, Jesse, too, you lack impact star players.
And Jed, and I think we all probably got a little fooled last year thinking, okay, 83-79, sixth in scoring, it's going to just continue to rise. One of Theo's favorite lines was, progress is not always linear, meaning you do this 1 year, then you go to another level, then you go to another level. Doesn't always work that way. But what does work is star players have more consistency than some of these guys that are second tier. So as good as last year was, it doesn't guarantee you this year. That's the big problem with the Cubs. And, frankly, I wish I would have predicted, because I've been on this lack of stars for several years now. But they did have a decent season last year. Okay, Ross left some wins on the table. Maybe this guy will get them to 88, 89 wins.
Right. And some of the younger players I thought would come up and help.
And where are they? Second-ranked farm system. What's it produced so
nothing.
Far? Wait, Hayden Wesneski?
No.
Do you like to call him home run Wesneski instead of Hayden Wesneski? He's got a little bit of that in him.
Oh, yeah, of course he does. They really vaulted him up to be like the eighth inning guy quickly, yeah. and he gives up the home run quickly.
Tyson Miller gave up a 450-foot home run yesterday. It was crushed. They have just
This was after goals. A couple days ago where he gave up like a 400-foot foul ball followed by a 400-foot home run.
And then in between, these guys have occasional good outings, but when your offense is kind of bad, it exposes your bullpen even more and vice versa in a way. Ed Policy, you know what that is? He's going to succeed Mark Murphy as Packers president and CEO in 2025. Will assume the new role when the NFL's only publicly owned franchise holds its shareholders meeting in July 2025. Policy is the son of former 49ers and Browns president Carmen Policy. Wow. Murphy has been president and CEO since 2008. He reaches the mandatory retirement age of 70 in July 2025. So remains to be seen what changes. The Packers have been a pretty good machine over the years.
Yes.
With him in charge.
And it doesn't matter.
Right. It really doesn't.
Keep on selling that fake stock. People, right. Those dummies will keep on buying it. But they keep on winning.
Now I think I'm out of those.
So you have the fun stories next?
I have the fun stories. Is that now or after the break?
What do you think?
I honestly don't remember.
How much time is left on the clock here?
It says zero.
Okay, so is it now or after the break?
More after the break in Waddle's World. Let's continue on with Waddle's World. And this first story, Silvy, is of interest to me. Because as a reporter, as you know, your phone pretty much has to be on 365, right? News can break anytime. In any field, sports, news, regular news, politics, you're breaking at any time. So here's this story. Half of Americans work while on vacation and feel guilty for taking one. For all the talk of work-life balance and taking the time to unplug from the job, most Americans cannot completely step away from the grind, even when they take time off to do just that. In a new survey by Communications agency, 54% of 2,000 adults polled say they work while on vacation, and roughly half say they feel guilty on vacation, whether they're working or not. That is a sad state of affairs that we have, a lot of us have that ingrained in us that we can't step away. And
how,
I feel
how
like
are
I'm
you?
A,
how are
I'm
you?
A, I'm a little bit like that. I'll go back. I was in Cancun when Theo quit. And, it's like I was...
Did you file from Cancun?
I did.
Yeah?
I think I came on with you from Cancun, to be honest,
really?
If I remember.
I used to be like that.
Theo even called me. He called me. He's like, I know you're not in town. He was, like, really nice about it. I didn't want to blow up your vacation, blah, blah, blah. It is tough to step away.
Well, a reporter, I think, is different.
Yeah.
I used to be like that. You know what changed me a lot is obviously getting sick. But also, you know what changed me was COVID. So... when you couldn't go away for a year because of COVID, when we were limited on traveling and like, that was like the first thing that happened to our family was spring break was canceled. We couldn't take our spring break trip because of all the restrictions and people getting sick with COVID. So I told myself as we kept getting older that I was going to enjoy vacations, that nothing is promised. You don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. You don't know when you're going to get sick. You don't know what's going to happen in the world tomorrow. So if you have a vacation planned with your family, with your wife, with your friends, take it and appreciate it. You've worked too hard for it. And don't look back.
No, it's great advice. You know what I mean? Like, and here's the other thing I've figured out also. For me, staycations don't work too well. Like, I don't know if I could take a week off and stay at home. The phone rings, the email. I almost make a point of getting out of town when I do have vacation. I feel like you can't be bothered if you're in well, Cancun or anywhere. Just out of town means out of town.
Sure.
You're arm's length away from it all. So I'm trying to learn that. But look at that poll. I believe that poll. I think a lot of people.
What was the percent again?
Basically 50%.
50%.
Feel guilty even taking one.
That's the reasoning behind companies giving out unlimited PTO is because people end up not taking it because they feel this amount of guilt that they have unlimited days, so they don't end up taking any of it.
Crazy.
Look, you're better as I know I am. You're more productive.
Yeah.
When you do, you're better. You're kinder to yourself. You let yourself relax. And if you truly do come back refueled, you'll be better the next 6 months, the next 3 months. If you do truly refuel, if you don't. Now, there's a different story. Like Yurko last year, I always remember this. I remember being outside the Coliseum at this time last year, tweeting about my opinion regarding Vooch getting re-signed. That wasn't Silvy being working tweeting. It was Bulls fan Silvy tweeting. There were some times where I could still let go, but why did I get in the business to begin with? Because I love sports. Just because I'm in Rome doesn't mean that I'm totally detached from being a sports fan. I could still be in Rome and still love sports and still have an opinion about sports. Do you know what I mean?
Well, of course. And a tweet is a lot different than you setting up the Comrex at the Coliseum and doing 2 hours on it.
So I can totally just detach from the sports world or from news. Because the reason why I'm in the business is because I love sports.
So for me, I think I learned from the Theo thing. As I look back, I can't believe I filed from Cancun because some guy stepped away from being the Cubs GM. Like, what was I thinking? But I did.
Yeah, but it was Theo too. That was a shocking story.
I know. Which is why I did it. But
and
anyway,
it's still having ramifications.
I think that poll was interesting and spoke to me a little bit. Shiny monolith removed from mountains outside Las Vegas. How it got there is still a mystery. A strange monolith found jutting out of the rocks in a remote mountain range near Las Vegas has been taken down by authorities. How it got there is still unsolved. It remains unknown how the item got to its location or who might be responsible, Las Vegas police said Friday. Its discovery over the weekend and quick removal because of public safety revived a pandemic-era mystery that captured the public's imagination when shiny monoliths evoking the object that appears in Stanley Kubrick's movie Space Odyssey began to appear around the globe.
Do you believe this is a prank? I asked Waddle this last week. Do people put these there to freak people out as pranks?
The short answer is yes, because I don't believe in aliens.
What do you mean you don't believe in aliens?
I don't believe they've arrived and that this is what this is all about.
Do you believe they exist?
I don't believe they exist in a way that they've, shown up on our planet.
Well, you don't think they're here?
No.
You don't think they're...
No.
Do they exist in the universe?
I mean, I guess there must be some other organisms in the universe, sure. Somewhere.
See, I'm kind of like you. I believe aliens exist, but I don't believe they're as smart as we give them credit for.
You know, that's something an alien would say.
Right.
How do I know that you two aren't aliens?
Yeah. I do not think they've arrived here. I don't believe in ghosts. I don't believe in ESP. I don't believe in any of that stuff. So.
You believe in ESPN?
I do believe in ESPN. That's a good one.
ESP. Like, I haven't heard anyone say ESP in a long
time. I don't even know what that is. What is that?
It's supposed to be, like, someone who knows what you're thinking. It was very big. ESP was very big in the 70s, wasn't it?
Probably.
We got a lot on the show.
Probably.
The quicksand and ESP.
Probably. What was that clairvoyant? What am I thinking of? That even help out the police sometimes? You know, I don't believe in any of that stuff. I certainly don't believe in talking to the dead. But do you believe in that aliens have visited?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
Why do you think that?
Because it would be dumb to think that someone doesn't have the technology to get here. We've gotten other places. How do you know what an alien looks like?
Well, I don't. You're right. You're right about that. It could be anything.
What are we seeing? We're like, all these things are just weather balloons?
No. They're objects, military objects that people don't disclose, countries don't disclose.
If you found out tomorrow that Cap was an alien mimicking a human,
yes,
it would not be that surprising.
Not surprising.
Good point.
San Francisco home selling for $488,000, but you can't move in until 2053.
Wait, what? What is this?
It's been apparently there's a three bedroom home in San Francisco, gorgeous neighborhood, and it's a steal for just $500,000. But there's a catch: you can't move in for 30 years because it's been, I guess, committed to somebody renting it until 2053. So I don't understand why anybody would even want to buy it. They can't even change the rent. I don't believe, according to this.
You pass the job down to your kids, though.
The current tenant pays $417 a month for rent in San Francisco. So you can understand why. But how this, they got it locked in for 30 years, I don't know. But I guess there was a line around the corner interested in buying this place.
Oh, wow. Whatever. All right, there you go. Waddle's World.